Today, Project Veritas CEO Hannah Giles has decided to step down, and she did not leave quietly. Instead, she actually completely scorched the organization with all sorts of allegations, and she did so in her resignation announcement. Now, many of the big names from Project Veritas are pointing fingers at each other, so I want to be clear. We have no way of confirming whose allegations here are accurate or true, but it does give you a sense of the chaos and the infighting that's been taking place over at Project Veritas, especially following O'Keefe's exit from the organization. So she writes in her resignation letter, "I am stepping down from all roles with Project Veritas and Project Veritas Action effective immediately. Though I had high hopes when I joined the organizations, I stepped into an unsalvageable mess. One wrought with strong evidence of past illegality and past financial improprieties. Once such evidence was discovered, I brought the information to the appropriate law enforcement agencies. Thank you." She ends politely with a thank you. Now, an anonymous former Project Veritas staffer spoke to Mediaite about this and said that when Giles referred to past illegality and financial improprieties, she was alluding to the following: unresolved lawsuits, the Westchester DA looking into James O'Keefe's spending, and the overall results from the internal audit. Now, O'Keefe, James O'Keefe, of course, is the former CEO of Project Veritas. He left following allegations of, you know, misusing the funds of the organization, including, you know, bankrolling his own fantasies of being some sort of entertainer. Now, here's what a private internal audit into the organization has revealed about the spending. There was a $208,980 charge worth of luxury black car travel over a 2-year period. There was a $600 haul of bottled water during one hotel stay in San Antonio. I'm sure that person has wonderful skin, but fully hydrated. There was even a $2,500 set of DJ equipment. O'Keefe dreamed of playing a set at Coachella, according to two former employees, and was irritated when his staff couldn't get him booked at the legendary California Music Festival.
What a loser. I mean, I say that not because you try something and you don't succeed at it. Hey, I love that, go for it, get caught trying, right? But look, if you wanted to be a DJ, go be a DJ. Don't take other people's money, rob them, and then use it for your DJ equipment, and then yell at your staff.
When you don't succeed, right?
Yeah, when you don't get into Coachella, which you never had a chance at in the first place. Like, if you got the stomach for the fight, and you yourself bought it, and you say, you know what, I know I'm an underdog, but I'm trying to get into Coachella, I'd be like, all right, have at it, brother. Look, it's kind of admirable. When you're yelling at others and taking other people's money to do it, you're so pathetic. So guys, the amazing thing about this, and there's a tiny bit of silver lining here, is that the people that go into these conservative organizations, some of them are genuinely surprised at the robbery. The whole point of those organizations is robbery. Like, they have all these nonprofits where almost all the money goes to the very top and to the people, and they're all being paid to do basically marketing slash propaganda for Republican Party and the right wing. And this, the silver lining is apparently there were some honest people in there, because they're like, whoa, what the hell? Turns out we were just robbing people. Of course.
So I want to actually get to the organization's reaction and response to a resignation letter and the allegations within that letter, because Bobby Haar, who's a former lead investigative reporter for Project Veritas, stated the following: Giles promised us everything and delivered next to nothing. Remember, this is a former lead investigative reporter for Project Veritas. Also, let's all laugh at the notion that anyone was ever an investigative reporter within this organization. But nonetheless, while Project Veritas may have been an unsalvageable mess, her skills as a leader are even less. She had no business being in that role from the beginning, and she knows it. Now, James O'Keefe's attorney also blamed Giles instead of his client, which makes me think Giles is the one who's actually being honest here. My reaction to her statement is shock. She's either demented or a grifting liar. That's definitely rich coming from the attorney representing O'Keefe here. He also continues to say, She told me repeatedly that a Project Veritas board member had forcefully told law enforcement that no such financial irregularities existed at Project Veritas during James's leadership. Now, after spending the millions left in the bank account, she changes her story, quits, and goes home. And a former senior producer from Project Veritas went after both of the former CEOs, saying the following. Project Veritas was fatally shot in February when James decided to walk away instead of face up to a couple management checks, allowing a misinformed audience to cannibalize it for social media clout. In August, Hannah put Project Veritas in a coma it will never wake up from when she fired the staff that actually did the work Project Veritas existed for. Now she's run out of money. The coma induced company can pay her. She's cut and run, leaving PV Project Veritas as good as dead.
Thanks God.
Sorry.
Yeah,
you man, guys, I thought the infighting in the left was bad, but this is a whole nother level, and I'm here for it.
Yeah, and after, because one of them is like, hey, I want the money for the DJ equipment. The other one's like, I want the money for my salary. I want the money.
What about my bottled water?
Yeah. And I shed no tear for the right wing billionaires that funded that trash organization to do propaganda for them. Oh, did they steal your money? No honor among thieves.
If you enjoyed this video, that's because of our members. They make us independent, they make us strong, and they make us honest. Become a member today by hitting the join button below.